Welcome to Trading Pulse channel. Thanks for subscribing our channel. So today we are going to talk about two important topics. One is put call ratio, another one is implied volatility. Okay, so these two topics which is mainly playing role in index options. Not only index option, in stocks option also is playing main role. First we'll see how they are calculating put call ratio. It's called as PCR. So first one is open interest of put option divided by open interest of call option. Okay, if the results coming PCR less than 1 means the people expecting to buy call options. If PCR greater than 1 means the people will expecting to buy put options. These are the calculations. Okay, we'll see in the real scenario. Okay, in the NSE website we have the data, right? So we can verify that only. And that implied volatility, there's very important things. They have two categories, high and low. If any corporate news or any macro news, some global news, anything comes to me, the implied volatility will increase. Okay, so if that time the stock price also will increase, means they expecting some volatility. So it will indicate you that volatility on the particular stock. Okay, but if it is the implied volatility is very low, people go and take buy options. Okay, for example, that implied volatility is so high means what will think about? For example, if you have a stocks currently it's at 100 rupees, suddenly it went up 110, 120. What they will think? In the level, so they will do the profit booking, it will come down. That's also, if it is implied volatile is high, we can expect some selling pressure on the particular strike price. Okay, if it is very low, or means the people who can buy in low level, that it will indicate that expecting the volatility on the particular strike price or particular stocks. We'll see in the NSE sites and all. These are the things, main thing, this is basic things. So if you get to know these things, we can easily trade on options, either index or stock options. Yeah, we'll see now. And first, before going that stock options, I will show you the one important things in the NSE site. They have a lot of things are there. How to call? We know how to calculate that put call ratio. They have we want to calculate. Index wise, stock wise, and F1 wise. So three categories there. So for that NSE, they have provided some reports. So some people may know about the reports. Daily they will provide the reports. They have a lot of information is there. I will show you on sheets. Okay. So this is the put call ratio. It's a put call ratio. Now see stock features. Stock options is less than 1. Stock options less than 0.46. So index option also 0.94. Totally is less than 1. So the people thinking they will buy call options. So it means market will go up. This is indicating this is a put call ratio. And we have lot of reports are there. You can see that NSE open interest and the bow copy and a lot of things are the bow copy. We can use it for your one strategy for through bow copy. Okay. And now I'm going to show you about participant wise open interest. That is very big, very important report. Participant wise open interest. If from the report we'll come to know who are our interest on option side, call option side, who are interested in a put option side. So it means who are going for lock, who are going for short. They will come to know. Here we can easily identify DIA people and FIA people. Where DIA people are is there, and where that FIA people are going and take buy or short. That kind of report I'm going to show you. That's why participant wise trading. Volumes also there, participation wise open interest also. Now I'm going to show you guys participation wise open interest. This is an Excel sheet I downloaded. See, so participation wise open interest. These are clients, totally clients, DIA, FIA. Okay, see, future index long, DIA open interest is 1800 only. But FIA, see, 90, about 90,000 people are there in future index long option. In DIA, future index short, DIA is so nearly 40,000 people are there. FIA, there are 56,000 people are there. So, if we compare with the two things, almost DIA, what we'll come to know here, DIA people, domestic people, they're selling their stocks, means they're booking profit. FIA, they're buying. So, okay, FIA is going to buy. I mean, they're buying, and in the future, they will going to buy. Then, this is future index. Now, future stock long. DIA holding nearly 36,000. See, FIA is having nearly 6,31,000. See, that is the variations. So, domestic people, they are in fairing stage. Okay, from greedy to fair stage. So, they are selling, they are booking profit. Okay, but FIA, they are entering now. If markets, whenever market correction comes, right, they will enter and get the some stocks. Futures stock short, see, FIA not selling. See, difference, see, FIA people, they are not selling. Only domestic people only selling future stocks short. Okay, then option index call option, see, they are not blue. DIA people not going for long, but FIA people are going for long. Okay, for call options. For put options, also same, FIA people only going for long, a lot of people are there. Index, option index call option short, nobody started from DIA, FIA, see, 1,31,000 people are there. That put option also like that. So, we'll come to know from this report, who are interested in buy side, who are interested in sell side. Okay. Now, we'll go into see that put call ratio calculations in the live from NIC site. So, we have right open interest. This is IV is implied volatility. It will show that volatility and the particular strike price. Okay. Now we'll go into so we have to take open interest, right? For put, this is open interest. Okay. So we'll calculate now whether who are interested. 417,46,500 divided by 3,752,99,25. So it is greater than 1. It means market will come down. That's what PCR calculation telling. So what we seen earlier, if it is greater than 1, people will go to buy put options. That's what the calculation also show telling is greater than 1 for next week expiry day. So, mean 29th. As per 29th, they're saying market will go down. So, the people are going to buy put options. Okay. Now, we'll see that Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty also will calculate now what's happening. 7802 7802075 divided by 9,436,150. But is telling is less than 1, so Bank Nifty will go up, but Nifty telling it will come down. That's what telling that PCR calculations. See that comparison, open interest from put option to call options. That's what it's telling. Buying Nifty, it may go up, but Nifty, it may go down. So, I mean, not go down. The people are interested, which side? So, we'll come to know, people are interested in which side. Okay. So, buying Nifty side, people are interested in call options. Nifty side, people are interested in put options. That's what it's telling that. For next week, only for next week. For example, we'll see November 3rd. That's very important. So everybody in this waiting for that US elections on 3rd is happening. So after that, we'll come to know what's happening in the market. There's a very big questions whether market will go down or will go up. I think you might see some articles. So a lot of people in this to buy on 11,000 put options, okay. You'll go and see that December expiry strike price and all. I've seen that on the articles, the people are very much interested in 11,000 strike price for December expiry date. Okay, we'll calculate now. 17150. Is a greater than 1. So November 3rd, the people are expecting to go to buy put options, because see that comparison here, have 170,000 people are there in call option side. Here more than 3 lakhs people are there in put side, because November 3rd US elections next week. Okay, so we have expiry date on November 5. That's why people are there in put side. So we'll come to know. So this kind of feature, this kind of analysis, if you did me, definitely you can achieve in option trading. So a lot of people are there in options writers and option buyers. We'll see in the next video, option buyers versus option writers. Just try to understand what's going on in the market. They see that our reports and all those things. I shown one report, right? It's very much, it's very good report for participants who are there in which side. We come to know. Then we can get some ideas from that market, whether it's go down or it will go up. Okay, we'll come to know that. That implied volatility, it will trade between the support resistance levels. Okay, if you reach the resistance level, definitely it will come down. If you reach the support mean, definitely it will reverse back. Okay, that mind it, that things and all. Okay, this is very useful things. Okay guys, if you like this video, you can like some videos and you can subscribe my channel, and you can refer to your friends also. If you have any concerns, any doubts, you can comment on comment sections. We'll see the next good video. Thank you so much for watching this video.